Good evening, everybody. My name is Kugan, and today I'll be presenting to you about a very significant historical event that happened 30 to 40 years ago in Singapore. As you can see, today I'm going to speak about the Maria Hertogh riots. Here are some of the contents that I'm going to cover for today. First of all, the objective, the introduction, content, conclusion, and lastly, some lessons to be learned. The objective of me coming to you and presenting about the Maria Hertogh riots to reflect upon a historical event that took place under the British rule and how the people responded to it. Also, to stress the importance of racial harmony between different ethnic groups living together in a society. To start off, during World War II, Japanese conquered Singapore. Singapore being a very racially mixed country, Dutch lived in Singapore. So the Japanese often targeted the Dutch and put them into concentration camps. So there was this girl, Maria Bertha Hertogh, who was an Eurasian girl. During World War II, her parents feared her safety and put her under the care of a Malay lady named Che Amina. After the war in 1949, her parents came back for her and wanted her back. This gave a shock to Che Amina as she loved Maria Hertogh a lot. She even renamed her Nadra. She raised Nadra like her own child as she did not have one. So when Maria's parents came back and wanted her back as their own child, Che Amina refused to give her back. This was when all the conflict started. Maria's parents wanted her back so badly that they had no choice but to bring this matter up to court. They pleaded with Che Amina to give Nadra back to them, but Che Amina refused to budge. She didn't want to give Nadra up so badly, so Maria's biological parents had no choice than to go to court. The court, made up of British officials, sided the Dutch and gave custody to Maria's biological parents. However, Che Amina explained to the court and told them how much she loved her and that she didn't have a child. So she appealed for custody over Maria Hertogh. In the end, her appeal was successful and Maria Hertogh, also known as Nadra, was given back to Che Amina. Che Amina was delighted, and a year later, when Nadra was 13 years old, she got Nadra married to a Malay teacher. This was the center of all the conflict. As she was 13 years old, she was obviously underage. So the marriage was considered void and was not recognized by the law. This also in turn angered Maria's biological parents as they didn't want to get her married off that early. So the most logical thing to do was to give Maria her talk back to her biological parents, and that is what the court did. Then, the Muslim community came in. Che Amina was rather popular in the Muslim community. So, the Muslim community sided Che Amina and they felt very angry. Also because the British officials in the court did not recognize their laws. This, however, was just an assumption and they got very angry. So they started to protest outside the Sultan Mosque. They started to throw rocks and behave violently towards the Dutch. This is when the riots all started. The riots lasted for at least 3 weeks. After the riot ended, a lot of loss was caused for the government. So, to conclude, the riot that took place over custody of Maria Hertogh made the government put more effort and importance in promoting racial harmony. Reason being, the aftermath of the riot caused a lot of loss for the government. Here are some lessons to be learned from the Maria Hertogh riots. The riots teaches us the importance of racial and religious harmony. Always respect the beliefs and culture of another race, no matter how your thoughts towards it are. I will now end my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.